Chair, honourable guests of honour, Minister, Minister from Ethiopia, members of this delegation to the Sixth Rural Water Supply Forum. In my organisation, we talk a great deal and we act a great deal about one important principle which we call equity and inclusion. Inclusion is about empowerment and giving opportunities to everybody. And I think we've just seen a great example of that in the performance that we've experienced. Equity is about fairness. I feel in a very unfair situation just standing here. How do I follow that? But I will try. I won't detain you very long. But I want to say a little bit about the vision that Rural Water Supply Network has for the future of this important subsector. In your conference pack, you have a copy of the vision paper which we recently drafted in either English or French. Some of you may have read this already. If not, I do commend it to you. I'm just going to pick on a few key points from that paper. I will not dwell on the vision itself, the vision of all people having safe, ready access to a reliable and affordable source of water, which lasts, which is permanent, which is sustainable. I think we talked enough about that. I think we all share that vision. I just want to take us through a few steps though. First of all, why do we need a renewed vision? I think we all agree that the progress in reaching the unserved in rural areas has been too slow. We all agree, I think, that the performance of services has not been adequate. Services which are constructed or physical assets which are constructed often do not provide lasting services. And part of the problem is that there are numerous organizations which do not always coordinate their activities adequately. There are numerous other reasons too, but these are just some of them. This lady on the right, Agatha, is the lady that I met and spent time with in a village in southwest Uganda some years ago. And I often think of her and her situation because she and others like her are the kind of people that I believe we should be serving. I don't want this to be a negative presentation. In the vision paper, we try to give a positive and an upbeat message. So there are things that have gone well. There are good examples of community management which is working. There are examples of local government authorities and others providing support to community management in an effective way. There are good examples of the local private sector playing its part too. And when it comes to financing, both at the local level and the national level, again, there are some good examples. And in countries, various countries, including this one, Uganda, sector reform processes and a number of institutional arrangements for progress in the sector have moved on a great deal in recent years. And we heard this morning from the Commissioner of Rural Water here in Uganda, just setting out some of that history of how we've reached the present day. But a number of things have gone less well. The first two are linked. We've pursued coverage. We've been driven by the Millennium Development Goals and by national targets, which rightly have emphasized bringing services to people who don't have them. But in pursuing that goal, perhaps we've taken our eye off the ball, off the goal of sustainability. comes to the financing of services, a great deal of the investment is focused on capital investment, the introduction of the physical systems, and much less on the important operation and maintenance needs that are required year after year after year. I think also we've failed to place sufficient emphasis on national leadership, national capacity, and the coordination of all the players at national and local level into national planning, operational, and monitoring frameworks. Let me just give an example here in a couple of slides of what can happen if we don't get the equation right between capital investment and recurrent investment. On this graph, which is it's simply illustrative, but it's illustrative of a country like the one where we are sitting now, with a population of around 30 million at the present day, but rising according to the blue line and according to the left-hand axis over the time scale from 2010 to 2050. Population rising rapidly. A country like this, if it invests sufficiently in new capital infrastructure and invests sufficiently in the operation and maintenance of services, can follow the black line. And looking on the right-hand axis, you can see coverage increasing from around 60-65% to nearly 100%, and perhaps staying there, or only dipping slightly if nothing further is done. The red line, however, shows a situation where capital expenditure is being made, and capital expenditures are going up, but there's insufficient spending on operation and maintenance. And because of the imbalance and because of population growth, what you see is coverage statistics rising and then falling. This is shown in another diagram. I'm indebted here to Patrick Moriarty from IRC, showing on the left-hand side when coverage is low, rightly a great deal of the expenditure is capital. But as time goes on, as more assets are in place, as coverage increases, increasingly we have to invest in recurrent expenditure and capital maintenance in order to keep systems working. And the red danger zone on this diagram shows that midpoint where coverage is around 60, 70, 80%, tending to stagnate and in danger of falling. If we think about the context in which we're trying to work, there are numerous trends. Trends in population growth, urbanization, trends in sector finance, the way aid is changing. Changes in the very people that we're trying to serve. We've probably addressed the needs of the easiest people to reach, the people who are nearest to the roads, the people who are settled. But what about the more remote populations? What about people with pastoral lifestyles who are more difficult to serve? And at the community level itself, at the household level, the individuals who perhaps have difficulty accessing services because of age or disability or other aspect of exclusion. And of course, we're battling too against numerous environmental trends, including climate change, but not only climate change. In the vision paper, we set out three things that we believe need to change, three priorities for the future. The first is to put a great deal of emphasis on permanent services for all. In other words, inclusive, sustainable, rural water supply services. To get there, we highlight two particular factors. Firstly, strong national capacity and leadership, with the emphasis here on national, not external. Development partners being exactly that, partners in the development of nations, led by those nation states. And secondly, predictable, balanced, targeted finance, so that aid and national expenditure are predictable, so that line ministries can know what they have to spend on both capital investment and operation and maintenance. In the paper, we identify six different stakeholder groups. Engineer Cabarisi this morning talked about everyone playing their part, all the different stakeholders being involved in this vision. National governments taking leadership, development partners having a very deep understanding of the sectors and committing to the long term. Local government working in support of communities and community management in order to achieve sustainability. Implementing partners and NGOs that are outside of government frameworks, aligning to those government frameworks and not operating independently. The private sector playing its part too, taking profit, but a fair profit, but operating according to high professional standards. And consumers, users, customers, demanding better services, participating in their design, their management, and participating in the form of tariffs and payments for those services, even if those tariffs are not fully cost-reflective. I'm going to leave it at that. I just want to emphasize, I think, that the vision that we have and the work that we're engaged with is a worthwhile one. I think we wouldn't be here, none of us would be here if we didn't believe that. We're all committed to achieving this goal. However long it takes, however hard the road, it's a worthwhile ambition. Thank you very much.